Good morning dear students. Today we are going to learn how to write the chemical formula. First of all, what was the definition of chemical formula? Do you remember? Day before yesterday we learnt about chemical formula. What is it? It is the representation of a molecule of an element or a compound. Element means when same type of atoms of one element, they are found in a molecular form like H2, N2, okay, molecule of an element. If we say that molecule of a compound, then like H2O, CO2, NaCl, like this, okay. So, it is the representation of a molecule of an element or a compound using symbols. Do you remember what were the symbols? Like carbon was represented by C, capital C, calcium by Ca, copper by Cu, okay, chromium by Cr. So like this, different symbols, boron, B, okay, same way, nitrogen with M, neon with Ne, aluminium with Al, uppercase and lowercase U, I hope you remember that. So chemical formula are the representation. The other formula is singular, formulae, F-O-R-M-U-L-A-E, is plural, okay. So it is representation of a molecule, of an element or a compound using symbols. So today we are going to learn how the chemical formulae are made or written. They are derived. Okay. Oxygen, O2 is the molecular form, but atomic form is O. Same way H2O. When water is formed, it means two hydrogen and one oxygen. How they are, why it is so that H2O is H2 and oxygen 1. So today we will learn how to write chemical formulae of compounds which are having two elements in them. Okay, how many elements? Two elements. So let us see what are the various steps. First step says that you always write the chemical symbols of the elements that form the compound. For example, carbon or water, H2O. How to make this formula? So first step is to write down the symbols of the elements that are forming the compound. So what are the symbols? Hydrogen H and oxygen O. We have written the symbols. Now second step says that write the valency of each element below its chemical symbol. Like what is the valency of H? It is 1. What is the valency of O? It is 2. Okay. First step was to write down the chemical symbols of the elements which are present in the compound. Second step is to write down the valency. Let me make it more clear. First step is to write chemical symbols. Like H-O. Second step is to write down their valencies. And where to write down? Below them. Valencies of the element. Like 1 and 2. Okay, this you will have to learn. Otherwise you cannot make the formula. First of all, the table that we did yesterday in the concept of valency, if you remember, that what are the valencies of different elements. From there you will have to learn. Now, after you have written the valencies, what is the third step? Third step says that you crisscross the valencies. Okay? Crisscross means like this. 1 and this will go to 2. Or you can say that oppositely they are going to multiply with their valencies. So crisscross. I hope you have understood what is crisscross. Crisscross the valencies and write below their symbols. Okay. sorry, below their elements, not syllables, but elements. They are elements. Okay, when you are going to crisscross them, and you, do you remember the word subscript? S-U-B-S-C-R-I-P-T-S, subscripts. What are the subscripts? These 1 and 2 are the subscripts. Okay, so what you will do? Then you are going to write down the valencies as their subscripts, like H2O. Chemical formula is ready. Okay. If by chance it happens so that here also, let us say like carbon dioxide. I hope this is clear to everyone. If I take one more example, for that I will just make it to carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen. Okay, carbon and oxygen. Now carbon, valency of carbon is 4 and valency of oxygen is 2. So first step is chemical symbol, second step is valencies of the element below their symbols, and third is you have to crisscross the valencies and write this. Write the subscript. Write the subscripts where, with the right of the chemical symbols, to the right of, right means like H2O1. This is 1, but 1 we will ignore. Right of the symbols. Okay, now carbon, fourth step we are going to learn here. First step, element symbol. Second step, valencies. Now third step is to crisscross. Okay, so it will become like C2O4. What it becomes? C2O4. Now don't you think that 2 and 4, they are multiples of each other? 2 has 4 as its multiple. So because they are having some common multiple, so what we will do? We are going to deduct them, or we are going to, like, see this 2 is going to cut 4 by 2. C-O-2. This is the fourth step. Is it clear to everyone? I hope it is clear. CO2. Okay, so 2 is going to divide this 4 because they are in ratio, so they can easily. So simplify the valencies by dividing with the common factor. So what is the common factor over here? 2. So it will become CO2. Is it okay? Let us take one more example. HCl. Chemical compound is hydrochloric acid. Yeah, hydrochloride. So how to write down? Hydrochloride, hydrogen and chlorine. Chlorine, Cl is the symbol for chlorine. Now what are the valencies? We will write down the valencies of element below them. So it will be like 1 and 1. How to write down? 1 and 1. Now, third step, crisscross the valencies. Is it okay? Now when you are crisscrossing, then what it will become? HCl. 1, 1. Okay? If you won't write 1, then also it will be understood that it is always 1. So, ignore. In this case, ignore the valencies 1. Same way here also, it is not necessary to write C1O2. Understood that it is 1C1. When it is more than 1, then only we need to mention. So, this is how we are going to write down the chemical formula. Let us again recall. Chemical formulae are the representation of an element or, of a molecule of an element or a molecule of a compound using symbols. Okay, so we are learning how to write down the symbols, chemical formulae. So first of all, you have to learn the chemical symbols for them. If you do not know the chemical symbols, how you will be able to write? So first thing is to learn the chemical symbols of the element, like nitrogen and chemical symbol of hydrogen H, carbon C, oxygen O, sulfur S, phosphorus P. So this way you need to learn all the chemical symbols. It's not very difficult to learn because they are simple letters, initial letters only of that particular symbol you have to learn, element you have to learn. Then second step says that you have to write down the valencies of element below them. Under them, you have to write down their valencies. For this, you need to learn the valencies, that what are the valencies of different elements. Okay? And what was the valency? It was the combining capacity of an element. So we have written here, for example, hydrogen has 1, chlorine has 1. If we write about carbon dioxide, carbon has 4, oxygen has 2. Same way, for now, what is the third? Third step says that you crisscross the valencies. Okay? And write the subscripts. Subscript means what? These. We learned beforehand also that subscripts are those letters or those numbers which are written below the line. And which was the below the line? For example, C and O, like this. We are going to write like this in the line, and 2 will be written below this line. So that's why we call it subscript. So these subscripts are written where? On the right side of the element. C, O, 2. Okay. Now, if the valencies that are written in the form of subscripts, they have common factor, then we have to simplify the valencies by dividing with the lows, whatever the common factor is. So in this way we can write down the chemical formula. So I hope these four steps will be learned by you. Okay? And one more was there, that if one is there, then we will ignore one. Okay? If one is there, then we are going to ignore. For example, somewhere it is like 1, 1, or maybe like 2, 2 each comes, then what we will do? Then also we will divide it because they are having a common factor. So now let us write some chemical formulae, and you will learn them by heart, and you will also come to know that how they have been done. So let us see. Okay. See, it is given in your book also. When you will get your book, then it will be easy for you to learn. But by that time, I am giving you some chemical formula. So, list of some chemical formula I am writing. Remember, formula is singular, and chemical formula is plural. So first, we are going to write about the oxides. Okay, some name I am writing, compound, and here I will write down the formula. Okay, formula, chemical formula. Chemical formula. First one, I am going to write down. First one I am writing, very simple one, carbon dioxide. As the name is giving you hint, carbon di means 2, oxide means that another one is oxygen. It is an oxide of carbon is having 2 oxides. So CO2, carbon dioxide, di means 2. Same way, magnesium oxide, magnesium oxide. Now see, magnesium Mg and oxygen O. Mg has 2, oxygen also 2. So what we will do? Crisscross. When we are going to crisscross, it becomes MgO, Mg2O2. So don't you think that they have common factor? So we will cut them and it will become Mg. So this is how the formula of magnesium oxide is written. Let us see next one. Nitrogen oxide, dioxide. dioxide. Okay, so formula is N and O. First of all, we will write down the chemical symbol. Then what is the valency of oxygen? What is the valency over here? It is 2. Okay, no, sorry, nitrogen. You just remember this because it is a complicated one. NO2. Okay, then comes sodium oxide. Sodium oxide. Sodium oxide means Na2O. Why? Na has 1, oxygen has 2, and then crisscross and it becomes Na2O. Okay? Fine. Let us see one more. Zinc oxide. Formula is ZnO. Why? Zn, the valency is 2, oxygen 2, crisscross, the valency is, and it becomes Zn2O2. It will be cut and it will become Zn2O. Okay, so like this. So these are some examples. Some more are there. We will discuss it tomorrow. So for today, what you need to learn is, what do you mean by chemical formula and how a chemical formula is written. Write down the steps to write a chemical formula and give some examples.